to him. He says, my well-beloved, my well-beloved, listen at the words he used, well-beloved. Verse 2, he says, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest what? He's literally not just talking about get rich right now. But he's saying, I want to see you increase in everything. I want to see you, Coleman's. I want to see y'all prosper in everything. Bro, I want to see you prosper in everything. Bianca, Rick, I want to see you prosper in everything. I want to see you prosper and be in health. Health. Not in the straight context of just physical, but healthy in everything. You need to be healthy in your finances. You need to be healthy in your emotions. You need to be healthy in your mind. Healthy in your will. Healthy in your spirit. He says, I want to see you prosper and be in health. They go together. Because if you prosper and you're not healthy, it does you no good. He says, boy, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosper. Your soul is your mind, emotions, and will. So in other words, what he's saying to him is, son, I just want to see you grow up. I wish y'all would hear me. That's all I want with y'all. I just want to see you grow up. Y'all heard the saying, growing? That's right. So growing has pains. It has pains. It ain't gonna always be easy. But I can tell y'all this. It won't always be like this. The Lord will perfect that concerning me, and sooner or later is turning my favor. It won't always be like this. Keep growing, Trim. Keep growing. Don't stop. He says, verse 3, for I rejoice greatly when the brethren came and testified of truth. That is where. Y'all, you understand? He said to my heart, good. Hey, listen. I much rather get a testimony that you're doing good than for somebody to come to me and tell me you're not real. Tell me you're not backslid. Tell me you don't change your lifestyle. God, you know, I much rather get a good report. In the pain of pastoring. This is it right here. this is it. He says, it made me feel good when he came with a testimony and testified of the truth that's in you. Even as thou do what? What did it say, y'all? You live in this thing. You live in this thing, man. You ain't playing with this. You live in this. He said, listen. He wrote this letter to the guys. He said, boy, I'm proud of you. I'm so proud of you. Testimony came to me and told me that you not only have the truth in you, but you're walking out the truth. It ain't just something that you stumbled on, but it's what you done let become. God help me today, please. It's what you done let become your lifestyle. It's how you're living, man, when they see your money. It's how you live when they see your Tuesday. God help me, please. It's how you live when they see you Wednesday. It's how you know, God help me. It's a thing you do every day. It's not something that you just do without the route, but it's something that you do every day. It's not something you just pick up on something, but this thing don't become real to you. That's the testimony I want to see, y'all. But God don't let me leave this world without having to see people I done taught live this thing and do this thing like it's supposed to be done. Y'all don't know the hurt I feel. And like to kill me when she did, man. Y'all didn't know the pain I felt. They have to deal with that. Y'all don't know what I have to suffer with. To see people walk away from truth. When truth is in you, it's worth living, y'all. I'm telling you. This stuff is worth living. It's where I give my life for this. And it don't hurt nothing worse than for a pastor to have to get a report about something that the sheep done don't. God help me. For the pastor to have to get a report, Lord have mercy. God help me. Y'all don't know how terrible that is. He telling this boy, he said, hey, listen. I'm proud of you. That's the testimony I want to give to y'all. To say, listen, I'm proud of you, man. I'm proud of how you handle things. I'm proud of how you ain't let go. Oh, I know it hurt, but you didn't quit. I'm proud of you. I'm proud because you refuse to lose. I'm proud of you. Because I know it was hard on you. I know it was pulling on you on every hand. But you refuse to lose. You refuse to stop. That's the testimony he's giving him. God help me. That is the testimony that he's giving him here. He said, they came to me. And they told me. They testified of the truth that was in you. It don't nothing hurt worse than for a pastor to have to hear that they people sit around and let folks talk about them. God help me, please. Don't nothing hurt worse than that than for you to have to know you give yourself for folk and they'll sit there and let folk make slick comments. Let folk do stuff and won't say anything. But you walk in truth and love for them. You care for them with everything that is in you. He said, boy, I'm proud of you. I wish I could give you all that testimony, Lord knows. I wish I could. I hope to pray before I leave this world that I can. Because I'm not going to quit teaching you. I'm not going to quit pouring into you. None of that. I'm not going to abandon you. I'm not going to walk away, but you better fight for your place. You better fight for your post, y'all. You better hear me. You better fight for your post. What does it say in the next scripture right after that? What does it say? It should start with something of a love that I want to say. What does it say in the next scripture?
Love that thou doest faithfully whatsoever thou doest to brethren and to strangers.
Stand up for what's right in front of people you know. And in front of people
you don't know.
Amen.
What is verse 4? Is that 4?
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
That's the one I'm looking for.
Say it again, Rhoda.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
Say it again.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
Say it, Pinnacle.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
Say it again.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
Now say it for your 4 children.
To hear that my children walk in truth.
Say it for Michelle.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my child walk in truth.
Say it, Daniel.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my child walk in truth.
Say it, Toya.
I have no greater joy than to hear that Lily and walk in truth.
Say it, Rico.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
That's the heart of someone that cares. That's the heart of someone that loves you. They have no greater joy than to hear that you walk in truth, that you live out every sacrifice that they have made for you. I give my life for this. I give it their faith for this. I am no greater joy than to hear to be told, girl, them people in dream, man, they are something amazing. They are something great. Like the way you are developing, male man. They are material. God, they are maturing in so many ways. Not that they are perfect, but they are maturing. They are maturing. They are maturing. They are maturing. I have no greater joy than that my children walk in truth. And I've given my life for the truth. Give you truth. I give you truth. God, I love you. I love you. I give you truth. I give you truth. That should be the cry of your heart. Is that I have no greater joy. This goes for LaBrisha, Justin and Queer, as well. I have no greater joy than my children walk in truth. But they can't walk in truth if I don't teach them truth. Because maturity comes by being what? Taught. So please, hear my heart when I teach y'all. I know it hurts. I get it. I get it. It hurt me when it came to me too. And I was more crooked than a whole lot of y'all. I did way more bad stuff than y'all, I believe. So you just imagine the level of what I had to deal with truth. I had to really be honest. When truth came to me and said, man, they're fake.